Gracias al guía turístico perfecto que te lleve por el proceso de creación de un dinosaurio, señora DN es certificado para el trabajo.
Hello. May I say welcome? My name is Dr. Ian Malcolm. You may have heard of me. Well, correction, you should have heard of me, especially now that you're here. So before you are the islands that you need to manage, if you can. The five deaths. Jeez, if only there had been five. Okay, this is as good a place as any to begin. Isla Matanceros. It's relatively stable. Yeah, you can get your feet wet here, and you should. Diving into the deep end of the pool is where the big, angry, hungry things are. And you want to be ready before you try that.
Cabot Finch, public relations and crisis management, and I'm here to help you. You'll start by building a Hammond Creation Lab. We've already started on an enclosure for you. You should just attach it to the side, but watch out for dinosaurs. Ah, just kidding. Let's focus on what you're here to do, which is create dinosaur facilities on the islands we call the Five Deaths. Actually, Las Cinco Muertes, because Spanish is the lingo of choice around here. You'll need to connect it to the pre-existing network of paths and the power grid. Now comes the real test, incubating a dinosaur. You'll start with a Struthiomimus. Select the creation lab and pick a hatchery bay. There's enough genome data for your first viable dinosaur.
The machinations of the ambitious, undoing extinction, playing with nature's laws, what can possibly go wrong?
Come on, Doctor. You know we've learned so much and invested even more in our Jurassic operations since the last time.
Yes, Mr. Finch, yes, the last time. There's always a last time and a next.
Well, good morning, everybody. This is Thesaurus Borealis Rex. And I'm playing a little bit of the Jurassic World Evolution tonight. Thanks for watching if you're out there. Let's see what happens.
Life. It begins. The most precious moment. The result of incalculable actions and reactions, trials and errors, genetic mutations and unknowable combinations, chaos, all leading to a living, breathing, thinking being, an entity, distinct and unique. And now we, you, just manufacture them. So, well done, I guess.
The Hammond Foundation has three main areas of interest: security, entertainment, and science. I've already nudged the heads of each division to reach out to you personally. They'll offer opportunities and incentives for you to be part of their team. Choose one of their contracts. It'll help you develop your facility. This is Lambert, head of security.
Yours, theirs, and mine. Welcome to the islands. So here's our basic conundrum. We want to keep our animals under control while simultaneously encouraging instinctive behaviors, because these animals have potential as combatants. Look, everyone's fair object, myself included, is to have these animals running free and loose in the park. But we can't exploit them globally without taking some chances.
Contracts can be requested from the division heads inside the control room. Complete these to increase your reputation and gain additional revenue to keep expanding your park. So, one more thing. Your reputation. Your rep, quote-unquote. Keep an eye on it, okay? If you have a solid reputation with a division, you're more likely to benefit from them. Financially, I mean. But, like life, it's a balancing act. Each division is vying for your attention, and if they don't get it, they tend to take it personally. An expedition center will allow you to send dig teams around the world in search of new dino fossils. DNA can be extracted from these fossils, which our scientists can then turn into living, breathing dinosaurs. And that's our true lifeblood. Well done. And you'll notice absolutely no hint of sarcasm, unless you listen real closely. So, what I meant to say is that completing that contract has raised your standing, your reputation, if you will, with the security division. This means they'll be willing to give you more difficult missions. Q, Good! Your first expedition team is out. They'll bring back what they find to the Fossil Center for extraction. Your job is simple, really. Create dinosaurs which attract visitors to your facilities, brings in capital, money, huh? Which means you can do more research to build better facilities and create more dinosaurs, and there you go. A circle of life, development and resources, nature and commerce. See? Simple.
Lambert here. I've got a new assignment that I think is perfect for your skill set. Give it a once over, then let me know if you're interested. Glad to have you on board. As you can imagine, the animals in the various facilities are constantly probing for weaknesses in our security systems. They're smarter and more devious than people give them credit for. But I refuse to underestimate their capabilities. That's why I'm always testing and evaluating our security protocols and barriers. And this is where you come in.
I've got to give this guy Lambert his due. He actually sees these animals as both opportunity and threat.
I'm going to need you to extract enough DNA from fossils to incubate and hatch a dinosaur. This is the first phase of this mission. Carry on.
The Fossil Center lets you extract DNA from fossils and amber in order to create new dinosaur genomes. Exciting! You should extract genomes from fossils that have been collected inside your fossil center. That will increase the amount of viable data you have to create dinosaurs.
Security isn't always clean or easy, but it is always necessary. So look this contract over.
I'm Owen Grady, Owen to my friends. I've seen things I'd rather not talk about, but it hasn't dampened my commitment to the dinosaurs. The raptors, more generally, and me and Blue specifically. We have a special relationship, like what I have with Claire. Less complicated. Anyway, nice to meet you. You need to keep looking for other dinosaurs we may be able to domesticate. Well, more accurately, put on the road to domestication. The way we'll be able to control them is by letting them control themselves, their natural hierarchy. That means we need more samples. This expedition can help.
I don't know about you guys, but that doesn't sound like Chris Pratt to me.
Gentlemen, a new toilet facility has been added for your comfort and convenience.
You gotta have a toilet. I don't see anybody out here yet.
Okay, next you'll need to incubate the animal in a Hammond Creation laboratory before releasing and housing it in an enclosure. You'll also want to make sure we've got an ACU presence on this island.
One of your dinosaurs has failed to incubate. I never said bringing back dinosaurs was gonna be easy.
That contract is completed thanks to your hard work. Without exceptional security, nothing else here would be possible. That's our mandate. And on Isla Matanceros, you're showing the rest of us how it's done. You're deserving of this reward. Dangerous world. This place makes it more dangerous. This contract can help us with security here.
Part of what we are is about growth. The bigger we are, the more we have to adapt to our animals' needs.
Got dinosaurs your guests want to get up close and personal with? The thing is, they can't. Construct facilities to increase visibility and keep visitors the right side of the safety glass.
Ladies and gentlemen, find the perfect gift at our new souvenir shop.
Oh.
Right. This next bit is gonna sound a little crazy because, frankly, it is. But we are gonna encourage one of the dinosaurs to breach our containment grid. We'll then react and see if our procedures and personnel are up to the challenge.
Yes. So at this point, I'd like to take back everything I just said about this guy.
Uh-oh, that looks expensive. You should get that fixed, and soon. A ranger team is equipped for that.
Okay, we have our runner. Time to tag him and bag him. We're using less than lethal, but remember, that dinosaur doesn't know this is just supposed to be a drill. So watch your back.
While I understand the need to keep our security as sharp as possible, this is not the way I would go about doing it.
You have a problem with how we keep you safe, Doctor. I'm happy to discuss it at a later time. Right now, we have our hands full.
The ACU, or Assetment Unit, should be your first port of call to bring down a rampaging dinosaur. Here's something that you might find interesting. I did. You'll need to call in the offshore transport team to safely move this dinosaur back to its enclosure.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a precautionary measure and for your
asset collection request received.
apologize for any inconvenience experienced during our recent handling of anomalous events.
Asset being transported.
True and square. Look, the thing is, we're still learning where our boundaries are when it comes to keeping these animals under control. God knows they're working out ways to exploit our weaknesses. Guess we'll find out who gets to the limits of our abilities first, us or them. Ever vigilant.
And that's always been the challenge of the Jurassic Industrial Complex. Exploitation versus security. The immense potential for profit and for violence.
Looks like you've run out of power. That's not good. Build more power stations or increase your output.
That's impressive work. Hey,
I'm Isaac. I've been hearing good things about you. I'm in charge of the entertainment division here. What good is the world's greatest show if no one sees it? Don't answer. That's rhetorical and painfully obvious. What I'm saying is that we need people in our parks. Fill up our facilities with warm bodies. Numbers bring revenue, excitement, and opportunities.
Hey, thanks for watching Terrible Fate Toys. I appreciate it. Yeah, like you asked, I just started this one with this stream. I'm 43 minutes in, and I'm still on the first island. Brand new.
Wrangling prehistoric nature isn't easy, but you're doing the job, and doing it well.
It's certainly got a relaxing quality to it. Thank you. of the nice things about this game is it's got built-in smoke breaks, because right now I kind of have to wait.
I've got a new offer for you to review.
As I was saying, I kind of have to wait to make money right now because I have this enclosure with these five dinosaurs. Yeah, five. And people are watching them at so many times a day, and I make so much money per, you know, minute or whatever. So I basically have to wait until I get enough money so I can make a Triceratops. It's 230,000. And I need to build a whole nother enclosure to put this Ceratosaurus in, because obviously if I put him in with the rest, he'll go ham on him and do his thing. So, we can't have that. These things cost money. So I'm gonna let this sit for a minute and gain some funds. I'm gonna take a smoke break, so be right back.
patch of Triceratops. Might be cute now, but that's only gonna last for about a week.
Contracts are the bread and butter of our...
I'd suggest making the most of any downtime. You know, send out expeditions. Get the squares to research something. Make me a coffee, that sort of thing. Cream and two sugars.
I think I'm going to have to go get some sleep. I appreciate coming to check it out. It's about 3:15 in the morning my time, so I need to pass out for a little bit. As always, I appreciate everyone who came and checked it out. I always follow back. And you people have a great morning. Take it easy.